All right, boys and girls, welcome back. Tone King here, coming at you live from the Tone Lounge. I have in today from Donner Effects. This is the Starla. This is they have three pedals in their lineup. This is the third. I covered the Dictator. I covered the Red Rocks. This is the Starla. Let me tell you a little bit about it. They say state-of-the-art Tremolo engine. We took a challenge, went a step further by designing the most compact size, top-sounding, all-feature tap-tempo Tremolo effect pedal nowadays. Starla is a synthesis of two precisely combined electronics, superb sound quality, analog Tremolo, controlled by a versatile digital tap-tempo microprocessor via optical technology, a light source, and photocell. And yes, I did read that. I always do my homework. I couldn't memorize that if I tried. I would give you, like, it gives you that warbly sound. You know, that would be my description. So there's lots of controls here. We have, let's see if you can see it on the camera. We have the depth, speed, waveform, volume, tap tempo over here. And this is kind of the on-off, right? Also known as status. You have an input, output, and a sync button. Let me tell you a little bit about it. So the depth is... the depth you got to hear, you know, it could give you that chop-like effect, or it could give you that real, just very subtle warbly effect. It says here, on a minimum setting, Starla could be used as a signal booster. Increasing depth control increases the tremolo effect. Speed, there are three ways to set the speed. You have the speed knob over here, and let's see if I could tell, oh, you could actually see it over here. You have one, three, and two, and that will basically, you know, double or triple what that's, what it does to the speed. So it says three ways to set the speed using a speed knob, tap tempo foot switch over here, you could set the speed. Or there is a sync port, which is right over here. Yep, you could see sync port over here, okay? Speed is affected by the position of the multiplier, 1, 3, 2 toggle switch. If the multiplier switch is set to a higher rate, speed knob's sweep will change as well, okay? So you have kind of, you know, added functionality over here by the sweep, you know, in terms of 1, 3, 2. Waveform, 8 different waveforms, and that is easier just to cycle through so you could hear what each waveform does. And then you have a random one all the way down there at the bottom, truly random. Volume, they added a volume for two reasons. First, to avoid noticeable drop in volume when the effect is engaged, which keeps an effect at unity, some may call it. They say, which is a problem most tremolos have. And second, to be able to use Starla is an excellent volume booster without adding any distortion to the signal when depth control is minimum. So basically, if you have depth down and volume up, you could use it as a boost pedal, which is pretty cool. The sync port, as I said, it allows you to communicate with other devices. Depending on how the internal jumper is set, which you'd have to remove the back plate for, it could send a control signal to synchronize other devices to its LFO rate, or it can low frequency oscillation, or it can accept control signal to be synchronized by other devices. It also accepts remote tap foot switch. Okay, chock full of features. Would I use the sync rate? Sync port probably not, but it's there. Apparently, there is somebody out there that could and would use that. And the fact that it's there for someone is, you know, it's a very well thought out design. Tap tempo is kind of what you would expect it to be. You tap it to set what that rate is. And then you have the multiplier, 1:1, 1:2, 1:3. That's the multiplier, the 1:3:2. That's a ratio. Once a tempo has been tapped in, multiplier switch serves as an in-time speed control. And then, of course, you have true bypass. Starla Tap Tempo Tremolo is equipped with microprocessor-driven true bypass relay switching system. Holding down the foot switch, the status foot switch during the power up allows you to preset whether the effect powers up in effect on or effect bypass mode. Runs on 9 or 18 volts. And I have over here the Dictator going into it, so you could hear it clean, which you kind of already did, and you could hear it dirty, which creates a chop, like a slicer effect, a chop effect. So let's do it one more time. Let's go through it one more time and check out all the effects, both clean and dirty. Here we go. By the way, you can see over here how the volume drops. And you can see how the volume went up. And that's because I had the volume all the way up and the depth down, and that's your booster. So if I had the Black Star on like a dirty, a super crunch or a crunch channel, you could use this as a booster if you wanted to use it as a booster. Right now, I'm just going to set it as parity, which means when I turn it on, it'll be the same volume as the amp. almost kind of like inverted phase. Square. It's like a sine wave. And that's all truly random. So you get the general idea. Let's throw some dirt on there and see how it handles with the dirt. There it is. That's the Starla. Pretty fun pedal, isn't it? So there it is. You got to see three videos in total on the Dawn of Prince Effects lineup. Very impressive pedals. Top-notch, top quality, very well thought out. Cool. Definitely has that cool factor going on. Love the Dictator's eyes. Love the Starla's, you know, eight waveforms, speed controls, the tap tempo. Even the look, the pedals are badass. That red rocks is a real tight pedal. I like them. I hope you enjoy the video set on the the Dawn of Prince pedals. That's all I have for you. Comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. You know, I dig it. Thank you for watching as always. I'll leave you all off with one of those bad boys right there. And until next time, rock on. Later.